We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we are looking at The Box, Issue 1. This is a four-part miniseries from Red 5 Comics, written by Joshua Starnes, art by Raymond Estrada, colors by Steven Della Sala, letters by Dave Lamphere, cover by Raymond Estrada. So apparently this guy, Leo Bloom, is a private detective that has a magic box. It's sort of like a bag of holding. If you're a D&D player, you'll get the reference, but he can summon things out of it that are useful to him sometime. Not every time. So there's these people that seem to want the box, and this guy is obsessed with the box, and he's been making it his life goal to learn as much as he can, while somebody seems to want him as well. And then Leo is at the police station visiting his girlfriend or whatever, who tried to frame him for murder, and that's when they say they need him to help find this missing guy. He talks to the box quite a bit, as if it's a living thing. It's not really explained how he got it, or his association with it, that sort of thing, or why he talks to it. And then there's this kind of confusing sequence where I don't know if it's the same box, but it's got like a mouth on it. It shoots some chains out. I'm really unclear on that part. That was a little confusing. So is that the same box or is this a different one? I don't know. But then he does some research and gets a clue, but that clue does not exactly lead where he thinks it's going to lead. The story was interesting, but I was very confused because it doesn't really introduce the character at all. There's a little synopsis thing on the inside front cover that gives you more background than the entire issue does. It doesn't explain who Tony is in the book. He's referenced, but you wouldn't know who he was if you didn't read the inside of the cover, which it's in a kind of generic yellow area that would easily be overlooked because it's on with the same thing as the credits and the indicia. So I think it did a very poor job of introducing the concept and the character. Some of it is revealed as it goes, which is fine, but I don't think it did a really good job of that. But the story does seem like it could be interesting, so I might pick up issue 2. Not real sure. Not a huge fan of the art style. It's very, very sketchy. Very rough. People look kind of the same sometimes. So I thought it was okay. But the fact it doesn't introduce the characters at all, and it seems like there's supposed to be a story before this one, I think really threw me off. So I don't know if this was a webcomic or something, but they did a really poor job of introducing the premise to the audience. Otherwise, the story is fine, but it feels like you should have read a previous miniseries before you got to this one. And I don't know what that series is or where I can find it, if it even exists. So I think they could have handled that better. Maybe a 2-page introduction to the character in the trade paperback would be in order to kind of fix that. I'm on the fence about this one because although the story was interesting, it did such a poor job of introducing the character. I was frequently confused by what I was supposed to be rooting for and what was going on. Is it worth the $4? No, because of the poor introduction of the character. But if you can find it in a back issue bin or a discount bin for a buck or two, I would say it was worth that because it was entertaining and it looks like it's got potential. They just did a really bad job of introducing the character to me. I have no idea who this guy is or what this title is about. You have to give me something to work with in the first issue if you expect me to pick it up. So I might give it another issue, but we'll see how it goes. That'll do it for this one. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you'd like to help the channel out in other ways, links to my Teespring store, Patreon, and Streamlabs are all in the description, or just share the video on your social media. That helps quite a bit as well. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.